Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at all the different options for changing your desktop background. So let's look at how to change your desktop background. Notice I've got a completely black desktop background. I like working like that, and it works well for making these videos because whatever picture might be back here is going to take up space in the video and make the video larger. So I keep it like this, but you can easily change it. You can go to the Apple menu System Preferences and then change it from there. You can also control click on the background and notice you can have quick access to it by selecting Change Desktop Background. That just opens System Preferences and takes you right here to Desktop and Screensaver, the desktop setting. So in here you can change the desktop background very easily. This shows a representation of the desktop background, and you can select a photo here. You can open and close these sections. Now under Apple you've got some preset stuff. So you've got like the default background here. Selecting Apple shows you everything. Selecting one folder just shows you a subset of that. So for instance, the folder Desktop Pictures, I can select the default one here or an alternate view of Yosemite National Park and various other ones. All I have to do is click on them and then it will change the desktop background. And I can go into a different folder here and see what's available and just quickly go between them. Now in addition to that, I've got some other options. One is solid colors. Select that and I have a variety of different solid colors here I can choose from, like the stark gray. I prefer pure black, so I want to go to custom color, and this will bring up the Apple color palette here. It's on my second monitor. I'll drag it over. There it is. And I can use any of the different ways of selecting a color to change the desktop background. And I can go to all black here very easily. And that's how I get that. Now it doesn't add it to this group here. These are just the default ones. But you can always select custom color and change it to any color in the rainbow that you want. Now in addition to all of the Apple default pictures, you can also go into your iPhoto library. And it gives you lots of options for doing that. You can go into a list of all your photos. You can go into events and select by event. You can select by faces, places, any other way of sorting them, including albums that you have made yourself. So you can essentially make up a smart album or a regular album and throw a bunch of pictures in there that you think will make good desktop backgrounds and then quickly access them. You can also go into PhotoStream and other parts of iCloud to access photos there. So you have complete access to your own iPhoto collection. Now a third option is to go under folders. Now this is where it's customizable. You can go into your pictures folder and whatever photos are in your pictures folder, I'll go into Finder here, open up in my main MacMost, which is my home folder, I've got pictures. And under pictures you can see I've got that one photo that it shows. But I can easily add other folders as well using the plus button here. I can go in and in my documents folder I've got a folder of pics. I can choose that one and it will add that there. Now I see all the pictures that are in that pics folder and I can select one as my desktop background. And I can easily remove a custom one that I've added using the minus button there. Now in addition to doing it through that interface, I can also select something here in the Finder and just drag and drop it to the preview section here. And it will just change it. Notice it doesn't add it anywhere in here. If I try to use this plus button to add an individual JPEG, it will actually add the entire folder and list it under folders here. But if I want to just change it to a specific image, all I have to do is drag and drop onto this and it changes it. So anything that I want to add, I can add just by dragging and dropping like that. Now I have some special functionality here at the bottom to be able to change the picture every once in a while. So what you can do is say select one of these folders here or a custom folder that you've added. Like let's select the nature folder from Apple. And notice it's not changing anything. I haven't selected a photo here yet. But I'm going to select change picture. And what it's going to do, it's going to take my folder selection and it's going to add that to this change picture functionality and change the background photo every 5 seconds. Now you could just do something more reasonable like every day. So every day it's going to choose a different background from this collection of nature photos. You can also have your own folder here. So you can put a collection of hundreds of your own photos into this customized folder area here. Set it to change picture every day. Select it and you'll get a different one of your photos every day as your desktop background. And you can also do the same thing using iPhoto. So for instance, you can select a smart album here of your most recent photos or photos that you flagged in some way or tagged in some way, and then you can set it to change picture every day to a photo from that iPhoto album. So it's quick and easy to do that, and you can also switch between having it go through all of the photos in order or select one at random by checking this box here. So you have a lot of different variety of what you can do with having the desktop background change on a constant basis. And if you select the solid colors option here, it will actually then rotate and change the picture between these default colors here. It doesn't seem to be any way to add your own custom color, but at least go between the ones that you've got here. Now for advanced users, you may be wondering where all of these pictures are stored and if they can be altered. If you actually go into the Finder, and I'm going to command click on the title here to go up to the Macintosh hard drive level, then go into the library, and under library desktop pictures, I'll find them all here. You actually see that they are stored in subfolders, like all the abstract stuff is stored in the folder abstract, and anything outside of that is what appears under desktop pictures. So you can actually change these. For instance, if I wanted to add this photo here, I can add it, but you're going to have to authenticate by using your an admin ID and password because this is at the system level, not at the user level. But you can actually alter this stuff or actually grab these photos if you want to use them for, let's say, a background in an iMovie project or something else. This is where to find them.